Hi guys, it's Gordon here at Avolites, and I'm going to show you some more advanced features that we have inside pixel mapping. In the previous video, you saw me record a red block just rotating on these beam lights that I have inside this shofar. One of the things that you guys might want to do after you have recorded your pixel mapping effect is change the colors or fade between colors inside a pixel map effect you've made. So I'm going to make another pixel map effect using these beam fixtures that I have inside my shofar. I'm going to make a similar block effect. I'll make it in red. And I will make it rotate. If I select the top of the layer inside the pixel mapper, I have the option to use a master. And this is going to be really useful for those of you who want to use pixel map effects in multiple different ways later on. At point of recording a pixel map effect, if I select this and then record onto a playback, then it's going to have the information stored inside this playback to pay attention to a pixel map layer master. You can see that this playback where I have recorded this pixel map effect currently doesn't do anything. This is because when I was recording it, I told it to pay attention to a pixel map layer master. We can put one of these on the console by tapping record and then soft key E, which is create master. Here you can see on soft key E as well, I've got pixel mapper. This effect I programmed in on layer one. So I'm going to choose layer one and choose the playback right next to it. Now, I'm able to use this layer master as in a very similar way to if it was a fixture. If I tap the blue swap key of this layer master, you can see on the bottom right hand side, I have the opacity of it. So I can turn this layer master up or down, the same as I can turn the intensity of a fixture up or down. I can also apply a number of different colors to this layer master. Anyone who is used to using live palette fade times, I can also use this in the same way that I would with a fixture. I can say 3 seconds, go to green, and this pixel map effect in 3 seconds is going to go to green. One feature that I find very useful, and it means that you don't have to have a large number of playbacks just dealing with pixel map effects, which is kind of useful. The other thing that I want to show you guys is the shapes and effects window. This is a particularly cool window where I can record pixel map effects as if they were palettes. If I create a pixel map effect, I might want to be able to apply this to one or a number of different fixtures. This is entirely achievable the same way that when you're programming ordinary color palettes, you can do. If I tap record, I then have a record mask where I can include or exclude certain attributes that I want. If I say that I'd like to record a palette and choose that I would like to record either a global, a shared, or a normal palette, then I can record it in this shapes and effects playback window. I can now select a number of fixtures that I didn't use to create this initial effect and use this pixel map palette on them. Because it is a global palette, it's going to share this information, which as you can see, that block is moving along these spots. Another useful feature already built inside Titan for you. Thanks for watching. Tune in again for the next one to see some more interesting features.